Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today I want to show you how to change your sections presentation skills. Before jumping this tutorial, I suggest you to watch the previous video. It's about creating sections. I roughly showed how you can create sections, how to change their settings, and I gave some tips. If you are okay with your main geometry of your sections, let's see what we can achieve together in this tutorial. Here we are in ARCHICAD and we can see our previously created section. We can clearly see our slabs, stairs, doors and walls. And also we can see our shadow too. It's a specific option activated from the section settings. To achieve it, we will go to section settings. Maybe from here by clicking settings, or you can go to the by clicking it on the floor plan with Ctrl plus T. And you will go to same settings. All of them is about main geometry of the sections, except one, the model appearance. Let's click it and look at what we have here. Let's say that you will create a presentation and details are not important. So that will be enough, giving only one color into all of your slabs, walls, and other furnitures. Now let's see how can we assign only one color. In the model appearance, we have uncut elements, but also we have cut elements. We have this cut fill. As it says, we are going to use this to fulfill inside with only one color, which is black. Let's click it, and from the settings, we will see some options. If you want your color coming from surface settings, you will select the surface color fill and surface color field shaded. But now we are going to determine the color from this menu. To fill inside color, we will select this color field and we will see more options. As you can see, we have this general options. Let's click it and click black and click OK. Let's go to the section and we will see this. Let's look at what happened if we select another. I want to assign a textured one, maybe brick. We have selected our brick, but we only see solid color. We cannot see texture. As I said before, to see the texture, we will activate this surface color fill, this surface color fill. This option will give us only color. This time, I will select this cut fill and click Uniform Cut Pens. As you can see, all of our cut pens is single line, which is 0.35, but backgrounds are different. Actually, all of these fill styles come from their element settings. You can change them from the element attributes from here, or you can go to options. Unfortunately, by doing this way, you have to fix them one by one. But fixing them in same time will be needed another operation. It's not our topic here, but I will show you how you can achieve that. Let's click OK for now. We will activate graphic override. Let's click our override. We will see some options. But we are not going to use any of them. We are going to create ours. Let's click this icon and we are going to create our new graphical override. Let's click OK. You can give a name here and we will add an option. Click Add, Create New Rule. Click OK and Edit. At the first, we are going to change our criteria. It says all kind of elements will be changed. So if we change here, all kind of elements, section or any settings will be changed according to those settings. But if you want to only change wall, you will select wall here. If you want to change slab, you will select slab here. For the demonstration purpose, I'm going to change all of the types. I'm not going to click anything. Now, from the fill type, let's activate it. and we will select a kind of texture according to our presentation. Maybe we can select food. Before moving further, you will see this option. This override will affect only cut field types, which is our aim, so we can continue. If it wouldn't, we could see this override cover field types, drafting field types. Anyway, now we are going to click the fill background pen. By changing this, all of the white colors will be changed to white. And this is going to be main line of your wood texture. It can be black. Let's click OK. And look at what we have. We have changed all of the fill textures only in one click. Let's try another one and be moving on. Click the icon. Click edit rules. I want to make white parts gray, so I'll change this to gray. Also, I want to change the wood style to aluminum, maybe, or masonry block. And I'm gonna leave fill foreground pen as one. Let's click OK and look at what we have. Oops, nothing was changed for the background. Let's go to settings. Look at what we have. If we check all of the settings, everything seems alright. Maybe we should check main section settings. Let's go back to the section. And I think here is the problem. It says cut fill background pen is transparent. Since it was transparent, all of the graphical overrides is not affecting, because this transparent value is resetting the graphical override settings. Let's change this. We will make any kind of color, even pink one, but I won't do that. I'll make this simple white. As you can see, even we did choose white, because of the graphical override, we see gray background fills. Okay, let's move from section settings. Let's click section again and look at what we can change. We have also very important thing here, uncut elements. Let's say that we are going to assign all of the walls concrete effect or maybe plaster effect. Again, as we did before, we will select this uncut fill and change its settings. If your texture has some texture fills, you can select one of these. If not, you will activate this surface color fill foreground. Let's click OK. Nothing happened because this wall wasn't assigned with any foreground texture. Let's click this and look at what we have. It's stucco quite fine. Let's fix it from the surface settings. I'll go to options, element attributes, and click surface. We see this stucco white fine instantly because we have selected it from the viewport. Now from the cover field foreground, it says background. It's not our target. Let's change it to make it similar, more stucco. We have symbol fields here. We have vectorial fields. Under the vectorial fields, maybe we can use this render. Let's click OK. And look at what we have. There we have our foreground points, which looking as stucco texture. By the way, those doors color field is not elegant. I think so. Let's change it in the settings too. We have an option here, uniform uncut pens. Let's activate it and select one color. Maybe gray is okay. We can hover over it and see the thickness of the pen. This one is 0.18. This one is 0.20. Let's select the thinner one, 0.18. And click OK. I think this is much more better. And I think it's ready to place our sheets. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If so, please hit the like button. And please do not forget to subscribe and hit the ring the bell. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave a comment in the comment section below. If you want to download this file or more advanced ArchiCAD tutorials, you can go to my Patreon page. You can find all of them. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day.